Well, they're fond of proclaiming the end of the world, but the end really could be nigh for Jehovah's Witnesses in Russia. A number of followers in the country have been convicted of extremism and of inciting hatred. The religious movement is outlawed in certain parts of the world, and Russia may be about to follow suit.
What do Prince, Dwight Eisenhower, and the Williams sisters have in common? They're all former or present Jehovah's Witnesses. Since appearing in Russia in the early 1990s, the Christian denomination has rapidly gained popularity. The organization says they have 200,000 members in the country. But soon, they could be classed as victims and criminals.
Now, this may seem like an ordinary Jehovah's Witnesses meeting, but if certain court decisions go against them, their activities could soon be declared totally illegal.
A high-profile case 5 years ago branded them an extremist organization that incites religious hatred and breaks up families. They were stripped of their Moscow registration. Although Jehovah's Witnesses were able to re-register, authorities have issued over 40 official warnings to them in the last 3 years. Their faith doesn't allow them to receive blood transfusions, and several have been tried for denying them to their children. Others have been imprisoned for refusing to do their compulsory military service. Critics complain the group recruits, then brainwashes its members.
My wife changed completely. She became isolated. She began to disappear for days and gave them all my money.
Jehovah's Witnesses were founded in the US in the late 19th century. There are over 7 million regular followers worldwide. But they say their unusual beliefs, such as refusing to vote or serve on juries, don't make them a dangerous cult.
A poor image comes from those in the media and the authorities who have no knowledge about us. When people meet us, they realize what good we do for society.
Jehovah's Witnesses are banned in China, parts of Africa, and some former Soviet republics. I asked an expert on religious law if the same fate awaits them here.
Personally, I think Jehovah's Witnesses combine the worst features of an international corporation that exploits its own members and a totalitarian state. But it's hard to prove what current law they're breaking.
Jehovah's Witnesses, people exercising their right of religious freedom, are a menace to society. The Russian state hasn't decided yet, but watch this space. Igor Gorodnev, RT, Moscow.